Hi, my name is Drew Lytle, and I want to tell you a story. And for this one, I recommend wearing headphones. I want you to listen to something. That was middle C played on a bunch of different instruments. So a question for you. Why do they sound different? Weird thing to think about, right? Your initial thought might be it's the shape or material of the instrument, and you'd be right. But to fully understand how all of these sounds can come together to produce music, we need to talk about physics. See, music, like all sound, is created from waves. Each sound wave has a particular frequency, and as the wave moves through the air, that frequency is what we perceive as pitch. Middle C, for instance, has a frequency of 261.6 Hz, and it sounds like this. But you'll notice that that doesn't sound like any of the instruments we heard before, right? Here's the cello playing the C again. And here's the pure C pitch. Completely different. The pure C sounds cold and boring. That's because when we sing or play instruments, we're never producing only one sound wave. Each note is made of multiple sound waves combined. I know that sounds insane, but we can actually hear this if we listen closely. As the cello plays the C, I'll just softly play the ones I hear so you can try to listen for them. There's the octave above, there's the one below, and if you really listen, you can hear a little bit of the fifth. If you didn't hear those notes, that's okay. I didn't for a long time. Keep practicing and listening. Go back and replay that section of the video if you have to, because once you do, music sounds completely different. It sounds fuller and richer, and like every note is a chord. And those are just the ones we can hear easily. If we graph the frequency spectrums for the cello, piano, and trumpet, we can see that there are a lot more. And what's really cool is that all of these frequencies line up regardless of the instrument. Here's the fundamental, the octave, the fifth, the next octave, the third, so on and so forth. This pattern is called the overtone series, and what gives an instrument its unique sound or timbre is just the differing volumes of these frequencies. That's it. What's really amazing, though, is that when these frequencies from all these instruments are so in tune with each other, their volumes are added together. And sometimes, one of the frequencies in the overtone series is so in tune and becomes so loud that it sounds like there is another instrument playing that note. This phenomenon is called an overtone, and it's one of the hardest things for musicians to create together. And learning about how it works reminded me of something my high school choir director used to say during really difficult rehearsals. Music isn't magic. And what she meant by that is music is really hard work. It takes a lot of time and deliberate practice for a bunch of people to come together and make something beautiful. But in that moment of beauty, if we create something literally out of thin air, then I think music is magic. It's just getting there that isn't. And it's kind of profound when you put it in the context of choral music, because humans don't have valves and strings we can manipulate to match our fundamental frequencies. Our bodies are not designed so we have a matching timbre. The only way for us to tune and to get to that moment of magic is by listening to each other and collectively compromising our individual voices to create an ideal sound. We have to think about being a piece of something bigger than ourselves and ensure that we are positively influencing the whole. And when we all do that together in literal perfect harmony, we create a magical effect that couldn't be achieved by any of us alone. And this is a lesson we desperately need to remember in our current political climate. If we want to solve problems, we can't get there by drowning others out and believing that this song is a solo. We need to start listening to those around us, balancing the sound so everyone is heard, and finding a compromise between our individual beliefs and actions that benefit the collective. Because when we do that, we are in tune, we are unified, and we have the opportunity to accomplish things that none of us could alone. When it happens, it's magic. It's getting there that isn't. Thanks for watching. I am a firm believer that the arts are an integral part of a civil education. If I've proven that to you in this video, make sure that your local representatives and school board members keep these programs in their budgets. Share this video with them. I'd like to thank all of my arts teachers for molding me into the creative critical thinker I am today, and I'd like to thank all of my patrons on Patreon, including Harry and Erika Lister, the Jeans family, the Lawson family, Andrew James, and my parents. You are all instrumental, in keeping this dream of educating through story alive. If you want to help grow Curiository out of my bedroom, head on over to patreon.com/curiository. Thank you as always for watching, and I'll see you next time in the Curiository.